Well, Juan has done so much for the American River and the canyons in introducing them to people through his paintings over the years. It gives people an opportunity to really look and see into the canyons in a special way that they don't unless they get down there and study it the way Juan has.
We brought to a conclusion some of our definitive glazes, using the bottoms of our glazes to sculpt out other shapes. In the panel above, we placed our dark shapes in front of the light shapes. On our rocks to our seascape, we place darks in the crevices and to define the rocks. We'll begin with a light wash, and remember, more water to our pigment gives us light washes. So we can start with a light wash back here in the background for the hills in Marin County. I'll do a San Francisco scene. We can darken parts of it while it's still wet. Don't have to worry about our brush strokes. And remember, with the bottom of our hill, we can start to sculpt out some of the luxury apartments that line the bay, San Francisco Bay. San Francisco is where I grew up and where I began painting with my teacher. So there's lots of very interesting houses and buildings along this part of San Francisco, different heights. We don't have to paint them all the same height. Don't put any windows in them right now. That window is just an accidental. Indicate these luxury apartments that overlook the bay. Some of them have interesting buildings, building tops, come down to the street level, and other buildings in front. Try and get them all different height, different characteristics to each one. Lots of buildings in front of other buildings. Some churches in the neighborhood. A Greek Orthodox church is down there. It has kind of a rounded dome to it. As long as the wash is wet, the glaze is wet, we can add more water to it. So don't be afraid to paint into an area that you've already painted with some more color. And then we have Angel Island out there. So that's a nice little hill off in the distance. We should be doing this out on location, and we will later on in lessons. All that I'm trying to do right now is hopefully encourage you to apply paint. And because I'm working upright, I'll have to come back with a damp brush. I've squeezed the water out of my brush, and I'm lifting out some of these little droplets. Sometimes we get a little too anxious and want to work into these areas before it has dried, and we can't understand why things don't happen for us. So we're going to take a break and let our glaze dry, and I'll return in a few seconds. Now, for the sake of accuracy, a pencil line would be desirable, but you'll notice that throughout all of my paintings, I have not put any pencil lines. I'm simply trying to illustrate to you that as soon as possible, you want to begin working with the brush, drawing with the brush, and avoid the pencil. Because what happens with pencil lines, I'm not objecting to it, I'm just trying to indicate to you that the pencil line is a little bit of a crutch, and I don't want to do that just yet. When we get out on location, then we can use the pencil line. But for now, we'll draw with the brush and put large buildings in here with the brush. Just a lot of what we've been painting didn't need a pencil line. But for the sake of accuracy on a cityscape, I definitely would encourage you to put pencil lines down and draw the city out with the pencil so that you have the accuracy of studying an area with pencil line. And I will demonstrate how drawings with pencil helps the watercolors. And so we're working back in here with a little darker wash, a little darker wash in some of these areas. And the thing to remember about these buildings is that they have air conditioning units, heating, some might even have solar panels on top. I don't know. Buildings on top, cone-shaped buildings. And I'm doing this from memory. So this is our inventive San Francisco scene. As I've mentioned, we will go out on location and paint some of these things and try to be more accurate with what we're painting. And we can skip areas. Sometimes the windows are on the corners of these buildings. And of course, there's the Transamerica building. A very interesting shape. Very bold shape for an architect to use. And architects are like artists in that they want to do something different. With our definitive wash, indicate Coit Tower, trees around Coit Tower, and the buildings in front of Coit Tower. Off in the distance, we'll be able to see these things for ourselves later. So stay with us, stay tuned, a lot more to come. This is just a further illustration of what to do. What I'm trying to illustrate every time I paint is that to use the definitive wash to sculpt out other shapes. And of course, being on location will give us more accuracy. Here are some other examples where I've used the definitive wash or glaze to illustrate the feeling and location of many places around the foothills, out in the desert, and throughout California. And with color,
we add a new dimension. This concludes lesson 4.